I want to get your thoughts on the Treasury market, which was in favor last week. Despite the equity market moving higher, we did see Treasuries get a bid as well. The yield curve has now flattened the most since August of 2007. What does that mean to you and investors?
Yeah, so Matt Hornbeck, our global head of rate strategy, thinks there's more flattening to come and that we'll be very, very flat by the time the Fed does a third rate hike in September. And as economists, I take that to heart because we look at what does the yield curve mean for the outlook? What does an inverted yield curve mean for the outlook? And while the Fed has been talking a good game around its consensus view that inverted yield curve does not necessarily point to an economic slowdown as it has historically or signal recession. I believe that when push comes to shove later this year and they're going into that December meeting and trade continues to pose downside risks to the outlook and the yield curve is flat to inverted by then, that they are going to take a pass on hiking rates at that meeting. I do think that they won't want to invert the yield curve.
Do you think when Fed Chairman Jerome Powell sits down on Capitol Hill tomorrow that this is likely to be one of the big things that lawmakers want to hear from him about the risk of inflation and this flattening yield curve and what's in store, not for the end of 2018, but for 2019?
Yeah, so I think he will get asked about the shape of the yield curve. I think more on their minds will be trade. Remember, the Q&A after his prepared remarks are where you really get into the meat of things. And a lot of the questions posed by lawmakers are for political posturing. Mm. And so they don't necessarily get at the exact questions that we would ask as economists or investors. But there will be a lot of talk around how much is trade harming the economy. There will be talk around the shape of the yield curve because banking will be chewing on the ear of some of these senators, wanting them to ask questions about that. And so I think that he's going to get a whole host of questions. But if I take a look at the monetary policy report that he'll be speaking around that was released on Friday, I wouldn't expect there to be many surprises. Also, because he spoke so recently going into this meeting, so we sort of know his views on everything. There's been no new data since then. I think he'll go ahead, continue to walk a fine line that trade policy is a greater risk to the outlook today, but we just don't know how to build it into our numbers.
Yeah, that's an interesting point, because despite the upward trajectory in the market, the recent economic data on consumer sentiment, I mean, it slipped in July, and it was a bigger than expected drop. And a lot of economists are attributing it to the latest trade tensions. What are your thoughts?
Yeah, the biggest hit to consumer confidence has been in the upper income group. So we tend to slice and dice it by income group when we get those numbers or by voter preference. You can see that Democrats' confidence is not very high. Republicans' confidence is very high. For the upper income groups, it tends to ebb and flow with the S&P or with market volatility. And, of course, they're the more affluent group that tends to read the news and watch the news more and knows that trade can affect their portfolios. And so when we see bumps recently in consumer confidence downward, it tends to be concentrated or has been concentrated in that upper income group.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.